Welcome back to the participants. Most of you would have come back by this time. What we are going to do in this session is to show you how you can connect to your mentor using AVIEW and how you can do the synchronous interaction that Professor Fatak was speaking about. So at this moment, you will be seeing a video screen of the mentor who is actually logging in from IIT Bombay. Can the video team just show the mentor? Let me just formally introduce him to the other remote centers. So this is Professor Sugathan from Agnel Technical College, Bandra. He is one of the associate faculty, and we have around 7 to 10 associate faculties from different parts of the, so the current associate faculties who are there in remote centers, who will have some participants with them. And what we are trying to show you is how a mentor can interact with these mentees. Please note that this is a demonstration session just to show you how this connection actually happens. So what happens initially is all of you will have to log into the mentors. Please note in the AVIEW you will have to, so can you focus on the server name? So you can see some server name, username and password, etc. So basically you will have to select IIT Bombay T10KT server, then we will be assigning you usernames. So you will have to provide the username under the username column, select the normal button that is there by default, and then give the password that has been assigned to you. Please note that all these things you will be provided with. So the mentors currently have these usernames and passwords, but the mentees will be provided with the similar username passwords in the coming days. So this is just a demonstration to show you how a mentor-mentee interaction can happen via AVIEW. So based on the mentor-mentee settings that has been set up in the AVIEW by our team over here, you will be able to see an appropriate screen over there. You will see a menu like this. So once the login is successful, so you will see a list of allotted classrooms to you. So for example, for each mentor, there will be separate slot number or classroom number that will be giving you. So, and it will be open only for a particular time slot. So for example, if say it is an interaction starting on Monday and the time slot is, let's say 3 to 4 PM. So you will, when you log in between 3 to 4, then only you will be able to see that classroom over there. And at the end of 4 PM, that class will automatically close. So you will have to be very careful that you log in appropriate time to interact with your mentor. And the mentors also have to take care that you log in at the appropriate time and make sure that you are ready for your mentees in the AVIEW classroom. So now what the mentor will do is they will log in to the classroom by clicking on join now. So this is an AVIEW login that is seen by the mentor. So you can see a presenter window and you can see a lot of people connected to this. So let me so now we'll have, we'll show you how a mentee can log in to the same system. So we have a test mentee over here. The mentees also will be provided with a username and password. So the mentee is logging in now, and so you can see a similar window showing what all are the classrooms available for the mentee, and he will join the appropriate classroom. So for the mentee, if you see, the interface is slightly different. The presenter window is coming on the left. And you can see different users. So they also can see the different users who are there logged in at the same time. So now what I'll do is, so for to see the video, what will happen is the mentor will now initiate a video transfer by clicking on the left hand play button that is available on the top left hand of the window, AVIEW window. So if you carefully look on the left hand, you can see a play button just where my mouse is. So the mentor will now start streaming his video, And when the playing video button is set, so there are some audio video settings that are shown. So the mentor has to stream both audio and video. So they'll have to select the appropriate camera, microphone. Please keep the bandwidth to 128 kbps. So I would want the mentor now to change the bandwidth to 128 kbps. 128. So what we'll do is, so in this one we are showing you FiTool so that there is clarity. In your actual mentor window you will see a 128 kbps connection. So before you can check the audio and video by clicking on the check audio video button that is available over here. So can the mentor now do a audio and video check? So you can see the mentor will see his own video, and there are ways to check the microphone, the bandwidth, the speakers. So all this are available. So you can perform one test after the other. So first check the microphone just to see whether you are audible to your audience. So when you speak, your the green volume levels show how much of the audio is see the green has now reached maximum, which means that your audio will be going at the same levels. So the audio levels will be perfect for an interaction. Now you can do a speaker check by clicking on the test button. So there will be an automated voice that comes, you can hear in your headphone. So you can stop the audio test. And on the right hand side, you can see that you can the video is actually coming. You can see whether the video is over there, and see the person who is standing behind the mentor is actually the videographer who is shooting this entire thing. So do not worry. If this video is not coming, then you have an option to select appropriate camera from here. You can change the camera settings. Currently the bandwidth is not, the bandwidth testing is not supported because it's still in the beta version. It is not supported in the main server. It is still undergoing test. So you can, now what we'll do is we'll connect to the mentees now. The mentor can now cancel the testing and start the video presentation to the mentees. So the mentee login. Mentee, you can start. So the mentor, what the mentor sees now is several videos that are coming in. So this is the presenter window of or his own video. You can click start. So the mentor can see his own video on the right hand side, and all the mentees have actually logged in by this point. And let me just ask the mentee to log in and see whether the mentor is visible in the screen. Please wait for a few minutes. It will take some time for while the team is actually doing the configuration settings over there. I hope that most of you would have got an idea of how to log into this system and see the video, present the audio, video, etc. Let me tell you one more goal of this session. So this session for the mentors, mentor-mentee interaction, it will also show you what kind of interaction you can have during the actual AVU interaction that is going to happen in the coming weeks. So the kind of questions that your mentor will be asking you, what is being tried. So basically the mentor will try to ask you about what is working for you in this course, are there any difficulties, what needs more clarity. So the mentors, each of these mentors have taken this course last year and they have successfully completed and became top performers in that course. That is why they have been assign the role of mentors. Now what the mentors will do is, mentors will as far as possible try to clarify your doubts through these sessions, and additionally if there are some doubts which are beyond their control, they will escalate it to the core stream at IIT Bombay, so that we will now see what are the major queries that are coming in. There will be some consolidation, and there are 170 mentors all across the country. So they will be first interacting with each other, and they will try to clarify between themselves, and then escalate it to IIT Bombay core team if there is no perfect resolution. So let me now go back to the mentor-mentee interaction. So this is a mentee's window. So mentee can see the mentor. So mentee means the participant of this course can see the associate faculty who is their mentor in this particular window. So now let us start a formal interaction. So I'll ask Professor Sugathan to initiate the discussion with a welcome message, and slowly do a flow transfer to all the mentees to get an idea of how the course has been till now. Please note that not all of your questions can be answered at this point, since this is a short demonstration session. But if you have some experience that you want to share, you can do it. Please be very crisp while speaking to your mentor, because we don't have too much time to interact. But in the actual mentor session, you will have almost 1.5 to 3 hours to interact with your mentor. Okay, so the mentor has some more facilities. Mentor can do lot of things in AVU. He can upload slides, he can share the screen, lot of different functionalities. We'll try to use some of them. So Professor Sugathan, you can start the interaction now. So what has just happened is the mentor has logged in, and so Jagpal Singh Rana from Noida had connected to the mentor and had asked questions regarding AVU, right, Professor Sugathan?
Yes.
So I'll just show you how to ask questions. So the mentees, what you can actually see is there is a hand raise button under the users list. So please do not worry if you are not able to understand clearly. There is a documentation that actually helps this. We'll be releasing this documentation in the IIT Bombay X course. We'll be providing the link for this, and there is also a video of how to use AVU. So both these are there. This is just to show you how the mentors interact with mentees and the kind of questions that the mentors and mentees are asking. So please focus on the questions that are being asked now. So the regarding the software part, there will be a separate link that will be provided to you. Do not worry. Okay, so now there are, you can see in the mentors window, there are these question marks being raised. So this is what the mentor will see when there is a specific question from any of the mentees. So you will not be able to hear the audio of the mentee, but I will try to give you the audio of the mentor.
Okay, so I'll go on to the next mentee. Good afternoon, madam. Please go ahead with your question.
Yes.
In a day or two, all the mentees will be getting their login ID. And the mentors have already been provided with the login ID. So the mentors and the mentees will be able to connect between them. The allotted mentees will be able to connect to the concerned mentor.
Okay.
Thank you, madam. I go on to another associate faculty. Good afternoon, madam. Ms. Shriya Sahul Hamid. Yes, madam. Ms. Shriya, madam, please go ahead. I can recognize Sharmila madam there sitting. Yes, I can hear you. Yes, please. Good afternoon, fine. Thank you. Please go ahead with your question, sir. Introduce yourself first. Okay, sir. Go ahead with your question.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, sir. All of us are new to this mode of learning. Yes. That's all right, sir. You will have more questions later. Good day, sir. Bye.
So, you were listening to one of the interactions with the mentee. So, important announcement to the RCID 1139, Mukesh Patel College. Professor Fatak is now at your institute and he is currently sitting with Professor Vijay Rajsingani. So, if one of you can just tell him where exactly your interaction is happening, he'll be able to join the interaction session now. So, RC 1139, Mukesh Patel College. Professor Fatak is waiting with Professor Vijay Rajsingani. I think he is in his room. So, if you can coordinate with Professor Vijay Rajsingani, Professor Fatak will also be joining this session. Yeah, so let the mentor-mentee interaction continue.
Hello, Nilesh Sabnis. Yes, so I can hear you. Please go ahead with your question.
Yes, sir.
Yes, go ahead, sir. Desai, sir. Okay. This is a very general question which everyone will be interested to know the answer about. Now, there will be various modes of interaction. First of all, it can be over the phone. We can have a WhatsApp interaction. Thirdly, we can have an email. And fourthly, over the discussion forums, we can have interaction. Now, it is between the mentors and the mentees. We'll have to, since there will be many mentees, there will be a fixed session which all the mentees will have to attend together, which will be mostly done at the convenience of the mentors. So, together, the mentors and the mentees together can arrive at a particular slot where they will be interacting. I hope that is okay. Thank you. Yes, Professor Praveen Srivastava. As far as I understand, there is no role of the mentees in assignment of the mentors to them. I don't think that facility of selecting the mentor is given. Now, as I understand, the IIT Bombay is running various algorithms for relating or mapping between the mentors and the mentees. So, mostly it will be associated with the domain over which the mentors and the mentees will be interacting. And it also may depend upon the college and the nearness of the mentees to the mentor. There is also a possibility that people or the participants from number of different domains may come under one mentor. Because the assigning of the mentee to the mentor purely based on the domain or the discipline will not be feasible. Therefore, people under different domains may come under one mentor. This will be basically, the list will be prepared by the IIT Bombay and it will be shared between the participants and the mentors. So, Praveen Srivastava sir was asking whether there is a choice for the mentees to select their mentors. Now, the answer for that is, basically the choice is not left to the mentees. It will be basically prepared by the IIT Bombay based on certain parameters and criterion. And as far as possible, domains will be matched, but every time the domain matching may not be possible. So, number of people, number of mentees belonging to different domains may come under one mentor. Good afternoon, Professor Anupama Alagannavar. Is it from Pune, the college? Pune. Quite a good number. Go ahead with your question, madam. You can give to one or two participants representative questions. Yes, give the mic to any one of the participants, madam. Yeah, you are audible, you are visible. I am able to hear you, madam. Yes, madam. Introduce yourself, please. This is a very important question you are asking, which I will not be able to answer at this point.
Question is a workshop for to become a mentee.
But I would like to comment on this. The IIT itself is delivering this program in a different mode this time. The mode of delivery last time was different from what is being done currently. So there are changes. Now second part of the question is that whether you can be a mentee. That I don't think will be possible, because there are more than 7,500 mentees already. Along with that, the mentors becoming mentees, the number of mentors will be less. So it may not be feasible. If you are not in the mentors category, you will be definitely assigned a mentor to you. Yes. Yes, madam. Yes. Please carry on with your question. Nice to see you, madam. Thank you. Yes, please carry on with your question, madam.
Hello, sir. I am Professor Mahendra Mehra from Father Consumer Rodrigues College of Engineering, Bandra. The question is it required that all the mentees to be together at the same time for the AVU session? And if not, if any of the mentees has missed out on the AVU session, which was commonly agreed by all the mentees and mentor, so is there an arrangement whether he can see the AVU session later on?
Now, basically, the interaction has to be simultaneous. All the mentees have to be together. It is possible that one or two mentees may not be able to attend at that time, but then he will have to make up himself by further interaction with the mentors.
We'll try to see that.
Thank you, sir.
That
answers.
Thank you. And you can personally interact with me, since I am from your own college. Thank you, sir. Now, I think this demo session has seen sufficient number of interactions, and due to the shortage of time, we are concluding it here. Those participants whose questions have not been answered yet, you can post your question here, and those will be answered later by one of the course instructors. Thank you.
So what we just saw was a minor demonstration. So I hope most of you were able to see the demonstration of the mentor interacting with the mentee, and you could actually see that the mentor was asking questions. They were asking to interact. Some of the questions would be audible to you, but what basically the mentor has tried to do is collect the queries from the participants, how they are doing. These kind of things have been asked, have given general guidelines and directions, provided motivational support to them. And so to continue the session, I'll ask the associate faculty, Professor Sugathan, to come over to this place where from where I am broadcasting and start interacting with the participants who are there in different remote centers. So I'm handing over the mic to Professor Sugathan, who will now be the instructor.
Good afternoon. I'm back with you. Now I would like to get your comments on what had happened in the last 20 minutes during the interaction between the mentor and the mentees. Now those who have any questions or comments, anything what you want to discuss with us, please raise your questions, do a hand raise. Lut Mata College, Trivandrum. Please give your comments on what had happened in the last 20 minutes. How was the interaction session?
So we have got a fair idea how the mentor interacts with the mentee. Mostly on the mentor side, we have some queries regarding how the mentee does the login and connects with the mentor. The mentee side, how he or she logins and connects with the mentor.
Let me just answer it from our side. All the mentees will be provided with AVU logins. So what we are doing is we are doing a manual entry of all the 7,000 mentees at our end in the AVU database.
Okay.
And so this is being a time consuming process. It will take us another 3 to 4 days to complete the mentee login to AVU. But as and when the AVU list is completed, we'll be asking you to, we'll be sending out emails to you saying that the login has been completed. And you can log into your mentor's slot. So initially what we are doing is, since this is a completely different experiment, a unique experiment that we are trying out. We are trying to see whether participants can interact with each other by use of AVU or other mechanisms. And AVU is one just mechanism, like Professor Sugathan told during the interaction. So they could use emails, they could use maybe different media that is convenient for them once the mentor and mentee details have been confirmed. So what I'll do is I have Professor Fatak, who is joining in from Mukesh Patel College. I'll just raise a question to Professor Fatak at this moment that even my associate faculty had. So are there any other queries from Lutz Mata?
Yeah, there is a follow-up question.
Yeah.
So for interaction, should we download and install AVU?
Yes.
And is it freely available?
So all the instructions regarding installation, downloading, there is a document and a video of it. This will be shared with all the mentees after the end of both days synchronous interaction. That means after 20th, it will be available in the IIT Bombay X site under the tab AVU interaction.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So I'll go to Mukesh Patel College right now, where I'm hoping that Professor Fatak would have joined. So is Professor Fatak in there, Mukesh Patel College?
Yeah, he's joining in 10 minutes.
Okay. So I'll come back to Mukesh Patel College in 10 minutes, and we will ask the different modes to Professor Fatak himself. So he'll be able to tell you why we are doing such a unique experiment and at this scale. So nobody in the world has tried out such a different experiment. So several MOOCs have hangouts or unhangouts where they connect using Google Hangouts on air, and several people join in on that. But such a disseminated form wherein you have one mentor interacting with the mentee. It has not been tried out anywhere yet. So we'll try this out and see how it is working. So let's take another question, and the mentor will be interacting with you right now.
We go on to another RC, 1088, KK Wag Institute of Engineering.
Yeah, I'm Dr. Sunil Kutte, and on behalf of all the participants here at this RC, KK Wag Institute of Engineering Education and Research, I wish you all very good afternoon.
Good afternoon, everyone.
My question to you, just to on behalf of all the participants, I would like to just have a specific slot for the interaction with the mentor, or is it to be decided with mutual convenience with each other?
Initially, it will be provided by the course team. The slots for each mentor and their mentees, slots will be decided by the IIT initially. But as it is going on, further interactions can be arranged between the mentees and the mentors. And there are various modes of interaction which can be done through the email or through the mobile or WhatsApp or whatever.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
This may not be directly related with the current session which is going on, but can I ask one little peripheral question?
Yes, please go on, sir.
Yeah, the biggest challenge which I believe for this ICT exercise which we are doing might be in the terms of that the human interaction with the teacher-student relationship is very much important. In ICT, how we are going to face this challenge of human interaction between teacher and student?
This is what we call the blended learner mode of learning, where we are judiciously mixing the personal interaction between the mentor and the mentees along with the online mode of learning. So most of our interactions will be, that's why today's session is arranged, to have a face-to-face interaction between the mentors and the mentees and the IIT course faculty. So it will not be a completely online course where the learner will not be able to see the teacher who is teaching. And most of us are seeing the interaction in the videos also. So it is not a completely virtual learning. There is a little bit of face-to-face interaction. The relationship between the teacher and the student is also being maintained. I hope you agree with me. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, sir. We appreciate the efforts of IIT Bombay in service of the nation and teaching community. Thank you.
Hope we will all together take the vision of Professor Phatak forward. Thank you. Now we have RC 1315, Dronacharya College of Engineering.
Sir, very good afternoon from Dronacharya Group of Institution.
Sir, good afternoon.
So, my question is technical related. Is it possible to share the screen between two mentor and one mentee? That means if I want to share the information with two mentor at the same time, or at the same time slot, is it possible through this software?
Not through it.
Because I want view from two separate mentor. Because we are sharing here on the mentor and mentee. But if at the same time I want the opinion from two different mentors, how is it possible?
Multiple video interactions are possible, but the video sharing can be done only through the mentor. So mentor has to come in, intercept in order to make talking between the mentees possible.
So at the same time is not possible, I think.
At the same time it is not possible.
Same time video
is possible at the same time, but audio will not be possible. With the help of the mentor, no? The sharing between the mentees can be made possible, both audio and video. That's what I understand.
If there is any connection problem with one mentor, then what happens?
Then those are all general problems which are to be attacked. If there is a connection problem, perhaps the interaction itself may not be possible. We'll have to use other modes, maybe through the phone or through email or other modes of interaction.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. GF Gardha Institute of Technology, 1059.
Yeah, yeah. Nagari. Good afternoon, sir. My name is Rajkumar Pawar. I'm from Gardha Institute of Technology, Computer Engineering Department. Now I'm using actually Google Classroom for the ICT, use of ICT to improve the teaching learning process. Many mentee can interact with the mentors anytime. That's a good idea. GIT College is running mentee mentor program since last 8 years, but it's an offline. So I see, sir, I thought the heavy uses of ICT education is not for the good for the students. One more point, mentor is motivating the students to improvement in their education, not only the subject related to the personal life also. Plus, sir, now I'm using Active Presenter for the mentee to prepare the videos or the subjects.
Now the points he has brought
up. Thank you, sir.
Brought out are, first of all, he is using Google Classroom. Then he is using other modes of online interaction. Also, he has brought out a very relevant point. Last 8 years or so in his college, mentor-mentee relationship is going on, but offline. Now, since we are currently talking about ICT mode of education, let us be focused on that at this point. Mentor-mentee relationships
are
always very good, but we are talking about the use of ICT in education. We are taking it a little.
Yes, sir. I am talking about ICT education. Sorry to interrupt you, sir. 10% students in the class not having mobile phones, smart mobile phone, laptop, computer systems in their home. Now, what the students will do? How they are going to use the ICT tool after the class hour?
I pass this question to Professor J.K. Madathil.
I'll try to answer this question in a more generic way. See, the question is, what happens to the people
who from rural background?
Yeah, yeah. So, what we are trying to do over here is, the government, IIT, or such similar institutions, and even the remote centers are trying to provide facilities for these students through technology to improve the entire teaching learning process. Now, we know that the last mile access has not yet been reached. That means we still have people who do not have access to technology devices or other things at their own place. So one example through which I can explain how it was done. So there was a open online course for school teachers that the interdisciplinary program in educational technology at IIT Bombay ran from May to June. Now there were a lot of school teachers in the nearby vicinity of a remote center in Tamil Nadu. And what the remote center has done was, they arranged lab sessions for these school teachers at their college on a Saturday or when the teachers had free time. So there is an equal effort has to be taken up by each individual institution, each individuals, wherein he will provide the support till the last mile access has been reached by the government or by several different programs. So each of us individually have to contribute to this national effort. So these blended interaction, the remote centers can provide these facilities for these students, maybe on a day, one day in a week, maybe 2 hours or 3 hours they can spend and use these ICT devices in their lab, or they can share with other students, etc. These kind of mechanisms have to be done at individual college level and by individual faculty also. So that then only this last mile access can happen. Otherwise, it is not that, so some people still do not have access to ICT. So unless and until we push for it, there is not going to be much change. So first, we ourselves have to try and do this. I'll just check with Mukesh Patel College whether Professor Fatak is available, because he will have better views and answers to this question. So just hold on a second. Mukesh Patel College, I am just connecting to you. Yes, Professor Fatak, I can see you right now. So there is one question regarding what happens to students who do not have ICT devices with them. How can the faculty provide assistance to them?
There are two answers to this. This is a countrywide problem, only limited to engineering colleges. Problem becomes more aggravated when you go to other colleges. To recall, the Akash project that IIT Bombay conducted was precisely to develop an affordable access device like this. It was contemplated at that time the government will actually encourage local manufacturing of such low-cost access devices. That has not happened. The prices are now coming down. We do expect that it will take 5 to 7 years for such devices to become universally available. So, as I was saying, availability of affordable devices is a challenge. What we expect is that in 5 to 7 years time, the problem of device accessibility and availability will get resolved. However, in the interim, there will indeed be cases where students do not have their own device. This is where we expect colleges and other institutions to provide access to such students. So he was explaining how some school teachers were given access by the colleges which had these facilities. So take this remote center where I am sitting in. They have one of the best facilities that you can imagine anywhere globally, in fact. And I am very sure that there will be occasions during days and nights and times when the facility will be unused. If all engineering colleges in the country, which are more than 4,500, decide to permit limited use of these facilities to provide access to students, including their own, I think the problem can be partially solved. No universal solution to it, but there are facility providers like us who have to come forward and match. As I said, the problem will be resolved over the next 5 to 7 years, but as of now, there is a problem. But I believe that availability of phones and availability of smartphones will happen faster than the availability of devices such as desktops and so on. Over to you.
Patak sir, associate faculty from IIT Bombay. Now, during the interaction, last interaction, one of the participants asked a question related to the use of other modes of interaction. If AVU is not available, then what is the other? What are the other ways by which the mentors and mentees and the teachers and students can interact? So I would like to.
That's a very yes. That's a very good question. In fact, this is a problem that is yet to be solved. And all of us together will have to come up with some innovative mechanisms to solve the problem. For the benefit of all participants across the country, I would like to once again thank more than 185 faculty members of various institutions who participated in our first pilot program and have performed well. They have kindly agreed to join as associate faculty, and he is one of them. By the way, I'll repeat my statement that from this particular FDP covering more than 7,700 faculty members, I would expect another lot of 200 enthusiastic top performers to join the ranks of associate faculty for the future occasions. And I would like now to extend the domains from which my associate faculty come. In the last FDP, majority of them were from the technical institutions teaching technical subjects. I understand, for example, at this remote center, you have some people who are associated with the Faculty of Law. Are they here? Wow, large number of them. So I would be very happy to have at least one of the lawyers performing so well and coming in the top so that he or she can become our associate faculty for future. Because the technology is meant for every domain of knowledge and every activity of learning. I digress slightly. Now, as I mentioned, what we are trying to do is prepare separate groups of mentors and mentees, with every associate faculty coordinating with about 50 faculty members answering their questions and so on. We had a challenge of connecting with these 185 people themselves. We first thought of creating a separate course for them on IIT Bombay X. Finally, JK came up with a stratagem, said, let's have a WhatsApp group. So I am now a member of a WhatsApp group where those 185 members are WhatsApp group coordinated. So one suggestion is, if the associate faculty agrees, then his or her phone number could be communicated to the 50 mentees, and then you could form a WhatsApp group. On the WhatsApp group, you can have instant connectivity, any message goes on to the entire group. We also perceived the possibility of creating a separate discussion forum for each such group. Currently, the logistics is against that, because we'll have to create 180 or 150 courses on IIT Bombay X to give isolated discussion fora for each individual group. We'll be sorting out this problem when our software for collaborating communities is rolled out in December. But right now, I would suggest that the associate faculty and the participating faculty who are going to be mentored by each individual should begin with some email exchanges. I know emails are very clumsy to handle and there will be a large number of emails. JK and I will think about it over the next 48 hours and come up with some practical solution where an equivalent of a discussion forum exclusively meant for that group could be made available. That's the best we can do. AV interaction with the allocated slots, it has never been tried earlier by us. It has never been tried by anyone. But I will tell you that today, in earlier when I went to Somaiya College, today I am here, the video clarity is excellent. The audio with some difficulty can be heard. At least if the mentor is speaking, we can hear. I think we should try very, very seriously to do this experiment of AV interaction between mentor and mentees. There's a lot of hard work. My colleague Sajjan Dikshit has to create 7,700 individual login accounts on AVU. And unfortunately, that system was not built for massive automation. And therefore, each one has to be created manually one by one. So some of my colleagues are busy doing this Golagiri as we speak. But we'll do it, because if 7,700 participants are going to be benefited, and it is an experiment that we're doing. I will only conclude by saying this. Please understand that, first of all, a faculty development program at this scale with more than 7,000 people participating is not done anywhere else in the world. We are the only ones. Second, within such a program, to conceptualize a smaller group of 50 people and 150 such groups with interaction and with feedback to the faculties of the main course from the associate faculty is again a global first. It has never been tried earlier. And therefore, there are no set mechanisms, no set procedures. It is not like using ICT for education, where there are at least 100 faculty members across the country who have used it effectively, and therefore they can share their experiences. So we have to create our own experiences. We will have to innovate. We'll make mistakes. Let us be prepared for that, but let us together try and work out a mechanism which in future FDPs we shall be able to use effortlessly. Don't forget, 350,000 teachers in professional courses and more than 1 million teachers in all of higher education need to benefit from these FDPs, and they cannot wait for 100 years. They have to be trained in using these technologies over the next 2 to 3 years. Please remember also that there is education beyond higher education. If you take high school education, there is no reason why the bright young students studying in villages, physics, chemistry and maths, cannot benefit from use of this technology to get the best of education at their doorstep. So those are the larger dreams. And all the participants here, plus my pioneering associate faculty, are actually creating history as we speak. We are all pioneers, and hopefully these efforts will lead to a pedagogy, a methodology, experiences which can be used by rest of the world. So that is what we are doing. I do not know how long it will take for us to finalize a working process. I hope that a working process emerges out of this FDP experimentation alone. So my request to all participants, not just to associate faculty, think of any brilliant ideas which can be used to easily create and operate discussion fora and discussion activities between the smaller groups of 50 and an associate faculty. I think I have spoken much more than my share of time. So back to you.
I would have liked to hear you more, sir, but go on to the next institute. RC1193, Professor Ramai Meke Institute.
Yeah, I am Ramai Kale from RC1193. We are getting motivated by the Dr. Phatak's speech. I have a question actually.
Please go ahead, sir.
Is it feasible that the we can use this AVU at the institute level after the FDPs are over?
So the question posted by RC1193 is, can they use AVU after the FDPs are over? So let me tell you, like right from the start of this FDP, we are focusing on free and open source softwares that anybody can use. So from, let's say, week 2, where we showed WordPress, it is a free and open source software. Similarly, Moodle, that is also free and open source software. IIT Bombay X, which is built on OpenEDX, that is also open source software. And AVU, the interaction that we are doing right now through AVU, that is also through open source software. So anybody can download the software at their end freely and use it. Now the setup required for each of these softwares are different, and all you would require a server setup in your institute to use AVU effectively. Now to connect to other remote centers during after the FDP, we'll have to come at identify some mechanisms through which post course interactions can be made through the same AVU login. We'll be thinking, so I'll be talking to Professor Phatak in the coming few weeks, and we'll let you know some mechanisms through which let's say post course interactions can be done. But the direct answer to your question, AVU can be downloaded and it can be used. All you need is other peers who will connect to AVU, some basic infrastructural requirement regarding servers, internet bandwidth, the audio video setup, etc.
Thank you, sir. I have a related question. Can I ask?
Sure. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Can you please cover sometime the legal aspects of the downloaded videos that we are using on the website?
Yes. So we'll be talking extensively about open educational resources and the legal implications of it, legal implications of use of copyright material. So Professor Phatak, in his initial first week video regarding academic ethics and integrity, had highlighted this point. So if you are using a material that has been posted by someone else without a Creative Commons license, it could lead, it is actually an offense. So we'll have to be really careful about these videos and other materials or educational materials. We may be doing it for the benefit of the students, but we'll have to respect the copyright or other aspects associated to those resources. And hence, we are asking everyone to keep all the resources that they create in this FDP in Creative Commons. So if you look at all the videos that have been uploaded, in the title, it will say it is under Creative Commons. Creative Commons by share alike or Creative Commons by. So there is a separate, there is going to be a separate module on Creative Commons license, and the associate faculty or mentors from each institute will be able to better help you. So you can post your queries to the associate faculty who have done this in last year's faculty development program. Any thoughts on it, Professor Sugathan, regarding?
Thank you, sir.
I would not like to comment anything more. We go ahead to the next college, RC1314, Kuttir College of Engineering, Coimbatore. Good afternoon. Please go ahead with your question.
I'm faculty from Department of Mechanical Engineering, Kuttir College of Engineering, Coimbatore. I understand through this mentor-mentee interaction, as of now, there is no possibility of mentee-mentee interaction. So,
during the interaction, the mentees will be able to communicate with the mentor.
Mentor. And this AVU software can be downloaded to any smartphone which is having 4G LTE.
Let me answer that question. So, I'll request our studio team, Mr. Sajjan Dixit, to come over and answer this query regarding AVU.
So the APK made by the Amrita University, and that can be installed on the Android application. But the drawback of this server side technology is that every individual connection requires 1 Mbps connectivity. So that is not possible for 7000 participants, because we don't have 7000 Mbps server load of the bandwidth. So it is not possible to use on the mobile.
But another thing is it possible in AVU to selectively record the path of interaction?
Yeah, in AVU the recording facility is available.
Yeah, recording is available, but I think it has to be recorded continuously, or I can just record a path of the interaction.
That is your choice. You have to start the interaction. When you are going to start the recording, you have to restart and then you have to stop. It is up to you. Only the mentor can start. Uh-huh. If you have a teacher privileges, okay, then you can record.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
We go on to the next institute.
Sir.
RC1098. Marathwada Institute of Technology, sir. Aurangabad. Please go ahead, sir.
Sir, I want to ask whether during that session, mentors can be interacting with each other mutually?
This will not be possible unless the one of the mentors will have to join as a mentee. Otherwise, this type of interaction, sir, may not be possible. Or else they'll have to find a common place where a number of mentors can come together and answer the questions.
So one mentor can be communicating with the 40-50 mentees he has been assigned, and they all will be able to listen and to interact with the mentor.
Yes. As I understand, number of mentors also can be allocated to a mentor, and if the other mentors join as students interacting with the mentor, then interaction between the mentors is possible.
Okay.
I have a comment
on
this
question.
We formed groups of the mentees. So the class will be restricted only for a particular group. So if any mentor wants to interact with some mentor, then he has to inform to IIT Bombay that I have to be allocated that class to interact with that mentee. Then we can add that mentor in that group.
Okay. So there is one more question. I will hand it over to her.
Yes.
This AU interaction is very novel idea. Through this we will be able to resolve a lot of issues which we get bottlenecked. But one thing I would like to ask, since we are forming a group of 50 or so around one mentor, is it possible that simultaneously a mentor can interact with two mentees and other mentees can see that? A kind of conspiring aspect?
This is possible. But it will be just like crowd talking then. So always the interaction can be between two people, either mentor, mentee. That is the way it can go ahead in the disciplined way. But interaction by the mentor with the different mentees can be made possible. He can selectively talk to one of them. Along with that, the facility of chat can also be used so that others can raise their questions, hand raises can be done. Those facilities are also there on the AVU.
Audible,
So one after the other only we will be able to tackle it.
Yes. The whatever talking is being done, it is audible to others also.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you. Now we are running short of time. I'll be able to take two more institutes. This institution is Birla Institute of Technology. 1331.
Yes.
Good afternoon. Please go ahead.
Yes. Good afternoon. This is Bishwatri Sarkar on behalf of Remote Center 1331. My question is, AVIEW is a software or system of your IIT Bombay. So what could be other similar softwares or interaction mode by which we could apply this mentor-mentee in our classrooms also?
First part of your question, you are asking whether this AVIEW is a proprietary software of the IIT Bombay. The answer to that is, it is not. It is prepared by the Amrita Institute of Technology, and currently it is an open source software. So anybody can use it. Second part of your question, whether there are other platforms over which the interaction can take place. As mentioned by other participants earlier, there are many other platforms like the Google Classroom. And personally, I am using the Moodle Cloud. Since my institution cannot provide me Moodle access for a large number of students, I am using Moodle Cloud, which has got a limitation of 50 students can be enrolled at a time. Now, since there are more than 50 students for me, I am forming two Moodle groups. On both of them, I will be uploading all my resources like the video, lectures, presentations, documents, etc.
Very good afternoon to Professor Pathak and entire team. Myself, Dr. Vijayanath from Birla Institute of Technology, Mishra Ranchi. I have developed the VLSI design course in Pavagi. Now that is available in IIT Kharagpur. Now I asked through this platform ki how pedagogy course will be active in this platform, by which number of participants can be assessed. Now, you know, this is the outcome-based learning. Everybody take the initiative, and it is a very good form provided by the IIT Bombay through the AVIEW software. Everybody can assess and doing such tremendous task. So now in the futures, we have asked how these things will be possible in our virtual classroom or in our present classroom. Actually, sir, we have a VLSI design course we have developed in pedagogy platform.
Yes, sir.
We wish to use that pedagogy courses in this platform online learning process, okay, and by which everybody and maximum number of people can use it.
That is a very good initiative, sir. You can use other learning management systems also for the this type of interaction between the teacher and
student. Yes, sir. Actually, we want to patch together, because pedagogy, they have so many courses have developed by IIT, NIT, BIT and all, okay. That how can patch with this program by which number of people should aware of that program and that subject, and they can assess it.
As I understand from the IIT team, they are looking into it. This will be taken care of. You can also send an email to the IIT Bombay team. You are audible. Go ahead, madam.
Okay, I want to ask one question related to this AVIEW, sir. It is shown that the document, whiteboard, video sharing like that, it is shown. But is there any demonstration class related to this one? Any demonstration? You have shown the video wall there, and we are using that. And is there any other demonstration class related to that whiteboard and all? It is shown there. It is usable, or it is just shown there?
Currently, we don't have any demo regarding that. But we have recorded this kind of video earlier, and that will be hosted on the site, so you can download and you can watch that. And regarding this, we also made a document on this, how you can operate the AVIEW smoothly. That is also available on our website, so you can download and go through it. And we will try to upload both video as well as the document on IIT Bombay X platform.
One more question, sir. Actually, in Google Classroom, we have the assessment, how we can assess the answers of the students using the online platform. And like that, is there any facility in this AVU? I want to know that.
AVU, direct interaction is possible, chat is possible, other modes are not possible.
So the assessment kind of things, AVU does not provide any facility, but the polling facility is available. If you want to get the immediate response from the user, connected users, then the polling facility is available. Using the options, you can get the immediate feedback.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. We are running short of time. It was a very enthusiastic participation from all the participants. And most of the questions asked were very relevant questions. I hope most of the questions have been answered properly. In case you have any more questions, and those questions raised by other institutions who have not been attended to, you can send those questions to the IIT team, either our AVU or in the discussion forum, and those will be answered. Thank you.
So thank you one and all for such a lovely interaction, and really sorry that we are not able to reach out to many others during this particular point of time. Due to the time constraint. So what we'll do now is, I'll give you a general instruction on what you have to do in the lab session that is going to come up after at 4 o'clock. So we have one graded activity that we have set up in the week 3 graded activity section. It's called lab assignment 1. So there are 5 multiple choice questions that you have to answer. Please note that since you are in remote center, we trust you and we trust the remote center coordinator just to ensure that people do not copy answers from each other. So this lab assignment will be open from 4 o'clock till 6 o'clock, so that you can take your time to answer the multiple choice questions. Apart from that, we will release 2 videos regarding visual presentation skills. Now, like Professor Fatak said, we are experimenting a lot of things in this FDP. So one particular pedagogic strategy that will come in the next FDP is flipped classroom. But since all participants have to complete this FDP and then move on to FDP 201 to understand the nuances of flipped classroom, we have thought of giving you an experience of flipped classroom in a student mode. So what we have is 2 videos by Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe on visual presentation skills that will be uploaded under the section Week 3 Flip Classroom Activity. You will have to ensure that you watch these videos before 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. So Dr. Samir Sahasrabuddhe's session tomorrow at 11:30 will be a follow-up of the current Flip Classroom Activity, where we try to pass on the information before the classroom and engage all of you in activity at the in the actual synchronous interaction. So like what Professor Sundar said did today, we had provided you some skills session as a week's videos, and today he actually did an activity where he made you pair up and then share the results to the instructor. So all these are pedagogic practices that you will come to see from our side and learn more about these pedagogic practices in the next FDP. So people who qualify in the current FDP will actually learn more about this, and you will have to create your own activities in the next FDP. So for the current lab session, the assignments are: do the lab assignment 1. It is open from 4 p.m. till 6 p.m. today. After that, the assignment will get closed. We will not extend the deadline for lab assignment. It has to be done between 4 and 6 p.m. After you have done the lab assignment, before 11 p.m. tomorrow, we would want you to watch 2 videos regarding visual presentation skills. Now, both these lab assignment and the videos will be released only at 4 p.m. So you'll be able to see it only at 4 p.m. And after you have done this, I would encourage all the participants to interact with each other and spend some time reflecting on today's activity. Ideally, all of you should note down what you learned, your thoughts about it in your course journal, which you have been continuously updating across week 1, week 2. So this course journal you will be taking over for all the entire weeks, and we would want the reflections of individual days interaction also to be reflected in your course journal. So there are 3 assignments in lab. One is a graded assignment. Second is watch a learning dialogue. Third is try interacting with each other and populate your course journal. So the AVO interaction session from IIT Bombay ends now. If there are any queries regarding the sessions today, please post it in chat. We'll be consolidating this chat till 4:30. So you can use the questions tab. So my studio team is asking me to use the question tab. So use the question tab that is available in AVU to post your questions. And while posting the questions, also see whether somebody else has asked the question similar to yours. So you can upvote that question to let us know that that is an important question. So 2 people would have asked the same thing. So it is always better that it comes, the upvote comes over there, wherein the instructor knows which are the important questions that needs more clarification. Now regarding AVU documentation and other things, we'll be providing you all the helpful documentations and videos by tomorrow evening, once the synchronous interactions are over. So I hope all of you will do the lab assignments honestly and sincerely without any plagiarism, and we'll watch the videos on presentation skills after that. Thank you.